Welcome to the National Registry Spinal Immobilization of the Seated Patient. You've already been given your candidate instructions. You now have 2 minutes to look over your equipment.
Okay. I have an extra patient collar. I have the TED device with two straps and a pad. I'm now ready.
Okay. The scene is safe and there is only one patient. The assistant EMT has completed the scene survey as well as the primary assessment, and no critical condition requiring any intervention was found. For the purposes of this evaluation, the simulated patient's vital signs remain stable. You're required to treat the specific isolated problem of a suspected unstable spine using a half spine immobilization device. You're responsible for the direction and subsequent actions of the EMT assistant, for which I will be for you. Transferring and immobilizing the simulated patient to the long backboard should be described verbally. You have 10 minutes to complete this skill. Do you have any questions?
Thanks, John. And so the scene is safe?
The scene is safe.
I have my proper BSI on this time. I'm going to ask my partner to hold the C-spine in inline neutral stabilization and not let go until I tell them to.
I'm going to apply my BSI. Sir, I'm just going to hold your head still in an inline position.
At this
time, don't move your neck.
I'm going to check for PMS of each distal extremity. I'm going to feel for a radial pulse.
Pulse is present.
Sir, can you feel this?
Mm-hmm.
Can you squeeze my fingers? Good. PMS intact. Check for radial pulse.
Pulse is present.
Sir, can you feel this?
Yes.
Squeeze my fingers. PMS intact. Check for a distal pedal pulse.
Pulse is present.
Sir, can you feel this?
Yes.
Lift the palm of my fingers. Very good. PMS intact. Distal pulse.
Pulse is present.
Sir, can you feel this?
Yes.
And you push up on my fingers. PMS present. At this time, I'm going to size a proper size extrication collar by measuring from the top of the trap to the bottom of the jawline. Apply my measurement to my extrication collar. Once I have the proper size, lock in the proper size. Start from the patient's sternum, work it up encompassing the chin. Squeezing and securing, making sure the chin is in an inline stabilization with the sternum. Okay. Making sure my leg straps are draped over the top so they don't get in the way. Going to position the KED device behind the patient, inserting the top of this KED device in first. I'm going to get in front of the patient and ask them to put their hands up on the steering wheel for me. Securing the straps, I'm feeding my straps. That's to not pull or jerk the patient. This time I'm going to reassess my torsion strap, asking the patient to take a deep breath in. Let it up. Deep breath in. Let it up. Deep breath in. And let it up. Switch the straps to secure and remove my leg straps. And advise the patient this going to might get a little bit uncomfortable. And make sure to shimmy my strap until it's in the proper place. Move into the front, pulling all of the excess. And feeding my strap until it's secure. And the other leg strap. This time I'm going to pad for any voids I see behind the back. I'm going to secure the head. Top forehead strap, angling it down. Lower chin strap, angling it up, making an X on both sides. This time the patient's secured to the keg, and then recheck PMS. Distal pulse.
Present.
Do you feel this?
Yes.
Excuse my hands. Good. Distal pulse.
Present.
Do you feel this?
Yes.
Lift up. Distal pulse.
Present.
Can you feel this?
Yes.
Squeeze my fingers. Distal pulse.
Present.
Can you feel this?
Yes.
And lift up. PMS attack from all four. Now that the patient is fully secured to the KET device, I'm going to move him onto a direct longboard. After we do that, we're going to strap him in, middle bottom top leg's head. After he's secured to the backboard, we will recheck PMS.
Have you successfully completed the station?
I have.